Good afternoon. My name is Lisa Balsera with USF Health. Thank you so much for joining us today as we continue our Facebook Live series in health and wellness. Today, I'm really excited to be at the new construction site of our USF Health Eye Institute. This will be opening in July here, and progress is really underway and taking great shape here. Our current Eye Institute of USF Health is still operational and seeing patients just down the street here on the USF campus. So here we are on the fourth floor of the Carolyn Frank Mosani Center, while progress is being made. And it's really great to have the chair of our department, Dr. Ramesh Ayyala.
Thank you. I am super excited. The new Eye Institute is due to open sometime in July, and we will have a grand celebration in August. This institute is going to be a state-of-the-art eye institute once it opens up, and I am excited to build one of nationally recognized top 10 eye institutes right here in Tampa Bay, using this as our background.
That's fantastic. So, Dr. Ayyala, what really motivated you to come? You were in Tulane University, you've traveled all over the world, you've done so much research. What motivated you to come here and take on this project here?
It's a challenge. I built Tulane ophthalmology from scratch after Katrina. We lost everything, and over the last 18 years, we rebuilt Tulane. It was phenomenally satisfying for me personally, and for the society as well, and for the residents and fellows that we trained there at Tulane. I did a similar thing in India. In Hyderabad, India, we established Ananda Institute, a research and training facility to train the local doctors in the state-of-the-art ophthalmology. When the call came from USF to help rebuild this eye institute, I was super excited. I looked around Tampa Bay. I think it's great timing and perfect location. Central Florida needs an eye institute that is nationally recognized. I believe I have the talent, and I believe USF has the resources for me to accomplish this.
That's fantastic. And you have a team and the breadth and depth of physicians and supporting team to really accomplish that here with all the different specialties, correct?
Yes, we're also in the process of building up the department. We hired a new glaucoma specialist. So our glaucoma center is going to be manned by three people. Every one of them super glaucoma specialists. We're going to hire a cornea refractive person in the next year. There's a pediatric ophthalmologist who's going to come on board in the next 3 months. And there is an additional retina person who's going to be joining us in the next 1 year. So yes, we are looking up. The team of doctors are going to be supported by very well-trained staff. And I am looking forward to this move to this new center. Yeah. Can't wait.
Great. And I'm sure it's going to be state-of-the-art, brand new. Can you talk about some of the new technologies that perhaps come from the department or as a whole that are going to be here that you're particularly excited about?
So this Eye Institute, this is a 27,000 square foot floor. We have about 45 lanes. A state-of-the-art anterior segment diagnostic center, state-of-the-art posterior segment diagnostic center on the same floor. If you walk that way, we have a minor operating room for oculoplasty. And then we have a vet lab down the corridor there to train the future surgeons. I tell you, this is going to be a landmark event for Tampa Bay and Central Florida once this is open. So we're going to offer state-of-the-art refractive cataract surgeries right here, and cornea laser procedures. In terms of glaucoma, anything and everything that's ever been devised, and we do a lot of research on glaucoma devices ourselves, will be performed in this center. Mm-hmm. My hope is to build this as the glaucoma center for the area, along with cornea and cataract refractive surgery. We are also going to build a ocular aesthetic department. If you look behind these walls, there's a special area that's demarcated with a very boutique-looking ocular aesthetic department that will benefit Tampa Bay people.
Wow, that's really great to hear. And then the convenience for a patient that's already perhaps coming to the Mosarni Center. We've got, it's a multi-specialty. We've got, more right. than 450 providers here. So
so the beauty of this is this, we are tying up with the endocrinology department on the fifth floor, with the primary care center on the third floor, and the ambulatory surgical center is in the second floor. For a surgeon like me, that's a dream come true. Think about this, any emergencies that come our way, we immediately can take them down to the second floor, do the necessary surgery, and cure the patient of their eye pressure, for example, in patients with acute glaucoma. So I think this setting is perfect for somebody like us, and I think this is only the beginning, I assure you.
Great, thank you so much. Michelle, did we have any questions come in from the live video?
So can you talk to us about how you got interested in this profession? I mean, a lot of the doctors we talked to have parents that were doctors, or is there something in your childhood that made you decide this is what you wanted to go into?
Oh, okay, a little story here. So my mom, I have a brother. My mom always said that I will become a great doctor and my brother is going to become a great engineer, and that's exactly what happened many, many years later. And so she was the inspiration to begin with. And when I was in medical school, I did my medical school training in India, in South India, Hyderabad. I took part in a lot of eye camps, and that's how I got interested in ophthalmology. And following that initial interest, I went to England, did my residency training in Liverpool, then came to United States to do my fellowship training in Boston. I did a glaucoma fellowship in Harvard, Massai Neuro Institute, and cornea fellowship in BU. That's where my research interest got going. And since then, I've been very fortunate to be associated with some of the top thinkers in this field, and I want to continue that tradition.
And talk a little bit about why this center is so important for Tampa Bay. Why having a state-of-the-art technology and some of the things that you'll bring in and the other doctors that you bring in, why is this so important for us to have here in Tampa Bay?
The center that I have envisioned is not only going to be important for Tampa Bay, but for this entire nation. This is the third center that I'll be involved in building, and this is my legacy for the United States. I want to leave behind a top 10 eye institutes in the nation. And that involves not only state-of-the-art patient care, but state-of-the-art resident training. So the next generation of ophthalmologists coming out of the USF eye system are going to be the leaders of the future. And also the research that we're going to initiate here, I'm hoping will result in products that will benefit patients. So my goal here is rather ambitious. A lot of people may think over-ambitious, but I know we can do it.
And you mentioned that you have a son that's in college now. Are they going to be, is he going to be an ophthalmologist or or an engineer?
My daughter is an intern in USC Keck School of Medicine. She says she wants to pursue gastroenterology. My son is a freshman in UCLA. He's pursuing neuroscience and bioinformatics. So we'll have to wait and see.
Terrific. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. And just to recap slightly, we'll be opening here in July. And in the meantime, patients can go to our existing USF Health Eye Institute just down the street. And we are so excited to have your leadership and vision here for this new center.
Thank you. I am super excited. And I can't wait for this new center to open up.
Thank you.